Hi there, welcome to Fact Friday. This week, I'm talking about the difference between pivotal behaviors and behavior cusps. These terms come up for us when we talk about what target behaviors we should be prioritizing. And there's a lot to consider, but behaviors that are pivotal or cusp should always be prioritized. A common question that I hear a lot is, what's the difference between these two terms? And what's funny is that many behaviors are both pivotal and behavior cusp, but still, there are distinctions, even though some people say they're sort of synonymous terms. So what are the differences? Well, let's talk about pivotal behaviors first. These are any behaviors which, when acquired, result in response generalization to untrained behaviors. So things like eye contact, approaching others, choice making, self-management skills. You can see that you can train approaching and eye contact self-management in one context, and then that could lead to not only exhibiting that behavior in the trained context, but also lead to untrained generalization or even maybe more sophisticated social skills or behaviors. You probably have heard it's often affiliated with pivotal response training and specifically training social skills to people with autism or other developmental disabilities. Learning to approach others is a pivotal behavior because what can it generalize to? Asking questions, social engagement, conversational language. Now, cusps, these are behaviors that result in accessing new environments. And so therefore, there's new stimulus controls and new contingencies, new reinforcers and punishers. Think of this as a behavior that opens your client's world to new contingencies or produces significant life changes, like, for example, crawling or walking, reading, generalized imitation, using the internet. All of these behaviors, when acquired, actually allot us opportunities. Like crawling is one I use often as an example, because the first time a child can crawl, they are now able to take themselves from one setting to another. And in that other setting, we've got new available contingencies, new reinforcers, new punishers as well. Same with walking, same with reading, and of course using the internet. That's the cusp of the century, isn't it? Because by being able to log on and go online, how much are we able to access? A lot, for better or for worse, right? So the similarity, both are absolutely building block behaviors and should be taught first. The difference, behavior cusps promote accessing new contingencies, new environments. Pivotal behaviors promote untrained behavior, promotes generalization. And that's important, right? Because it's time saving. We want our clients to learn a little bit from us, but in such a way that they can generate additional learning outside of a training environment or setting. Anyway, guys, I hope that helps, and I hope you have a great weekend. I'll see you next time.